Good morning. We greet you in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. So good to be able to come into your homes this morning again. Thank you for being our viewing audience. Thank you for greeting the Temple of Praise through social media. We're so thankful to be able to come into your homes and bless God with you. We just invite you to pray with us this morning. As we go to the throne of grace, we just thank God for this opportunity, this day that he has given us. This is the day that the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. We celebrate you, oh God. We celebrate you, God our Father. We thank you for another opportunity, another privilege, another blessing to be able to lift up the name of our Savior, our Lord, our rescuer, our developer, the one who comes to us when we don't know how to get out of the tracks we're in. He gives us victory. And we thank you, Father, for the victory that we find in him. Oh, God, we just celebrate you today. We give you all the praise and all the glory in the name of Jesus. We pray. We just bless you today. And we just celebrate God because he is worthy to be celebrated. He's omnipotent. He's omnipresent. He's what we need in this day and time. He's what we always need. So even as we sing this song, no matter what you're dealing with, no matter what you're wrestling with, no matter what you're struggling with, know in your heart and your mind that Christ has already given you the victory. We have the victory in Christ Jesus. Come on, praise team.
Hey yo, 1, 2, 3, get up, we got victory. No weapon they throw at me, you know it won't prosper. No.
Hey yo, 1, 2, 3, get up, we got victory. No weapon they
throw at me, you know it won't prosper. No.
Just got laid off,
I'm doing good.
House ain't even paid off,
I'm doing good.
Should be afraid, but
I'm feeling good.
All the time you say,
God is good. You can calm down, down, down. Don't forget who's in control. Walls are falling down, down, down. Get ready for the new Jericho. You're waiting on God. He's waiting on you.
So what you gonna do?
Ayo, 1, 2, 3. Get up, we got victory. No weapon they throw at me, you know it won't prosper. No. Hey, 1, 2, 3. Get up, we got victory. No weapon they throw at me, you know it won't prosper. No. Storms raging,
I'm doing good.
See the world changing,
I'm doing good.
No, it's not easy.
I'm feeling good.
Life can't defeat me.
God is good.
You can calm down, down, down. Don't forget who's in control. Walls are falling down, down, down. Get ready for the new Jericho. You're waiting on God. He's waiting on you. With all you've been through, now it's on you. So what you gonna do?
Hey!
Ayo, 1, 2, 3. Get up, we got victory. No weapon they throw at me, you know it won't prosper. No.
Prosper.
No.
present help.
I'm doing good.
He is your refuge.
I'm doing good.
He's your strong tower.
I'm doing good.
He's your way out of no way.
I'm doing good.
Yeah.
I'm doing good. I'm doing good. I'm doing good. I'm doing good.
Thank you, Jesus. We praise you, God.
Hallelujah.
We praise you, God, for being with us, God, and giving us the victory. We thank you, God. We will not allow our hearts to be silent, God. We will bless the Lord at all times, and your praise shall continually be in our mouths. We just thank you, Jesus, for walking with us, being our friend, holding our hand through every trial, through every trouble, through every situation. You are our present help. Oh God, we rely on you. Thank you, God, for leading us in the path of righteousness, taking us through every valley, through every shadow. God, we give you glory. And even as we sing this worship song, God, to bless and minister to your people, God, we pray right now in Jesus' name, Lord, that you would be blessed the more. We give you the glory. We give you the glory.
Glory, hallelujah.
Don't you be afraid. Joy comes in the morning. Troubles, they don't last always. For there's a friend named Jesus who will wipe your tears away. And if your heart is broken, just lift your hands and say, oh, I know that I can make it. I know that I can stand. No matter what may come my way, my life is in your hands. You don't have to worry, and don't you be afraid.
Joy.
Joy comes in the morning. Troubles, they don't last always. For there's a friend named Jesus who will wipe your tears away. And if your heart is broken, just lift your hands and say, oh, I know that I can make it. I know that I can stand. No matter what may come my way, my life is in your hands.
With Jesus.
With Jesus, I can take it. With him, I know I can stand. No matter what may come my way, my life is in your hands. Though your tests and trials, they seem to weigh you down, and all your friends and loved ones are nowhere to be found. Remember, there's a friend in Jesus who will wipe your tears away. And if your heart is broken, just lift your hands and say, oh, I know that I can make it. I know that I can stand. No matter what Jesus, I can take it. With him I know I can stand. No matter what may come my way, my life is in your hands.
We bless you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
We bless you, Jesus.
You be afraid. Joy comes in the morning. Troubles, they don't last always. For there's a friend in Jesus who will wipe your tears away. And if your heart is broken, just lift your hands and say, oh, I know that I can make it. I know that I can stand. No matter what may come my way, my life is in your hands. With Jesus, I can take it. With him I know I can stand. No matter what may come my way, my life is in your hands. My life is in your hands. My life is in your hands.
Yes, it is. Yes, it is.
My life is in your hands. My life is in your hands.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
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 Certainly thank the Lord today, amen, for this is the day that the Lord has made. The scripture says, let us rejoice and be glad in it, amen. We thank God for another Sunday worship, amen. We want to say thank you, the Temple of Praise, not only the Temple of Praise, but those who are watching who are not part of the Temple of Praise body. We want to thank you for tuning in to our website, to our via Facebook page to hear a word today. I do believe that there's a word in the house today. I'm going to ask you to do me a big favor today, if you will. I want you to come out the bed if you can, put your clothes on, and get out the bed and get your Bibles if you can, because I do want you to follow me. Secondly, I wanted to give honor and reverence to our senior pastor here at the Temple of Praise, Bishop John Chris Brown. We honor him, and we honor his wife today, First Lady of Brown. We thank God for her today. I do want to take the time to honor my wife in her absence today, Sister Raybette Stacey. God bless her. I want to say I thank God for the praise and worship team this morning. Amen. They did such a great job. Amen. Brother Jamal, thank you so much for carrying on. Brother Jamal, thank you so much. Thank you for all that you do. I want to give you flowers while you live. Thank the media team for their hard work in this time. Amen. We just want to give God praise today. We just give God the glory and the honor and all that he's doing. Despite of what's going on, we still have the victory today. Amen. So we thank God. Amen. We just give thanks to God all that he's doing in this season. Amen. So I do have a word from the Lord today, if you don't mind. I don't plan on being before you too long today. Amen. I know the media team kind of got on my case last month. They said it's going to be about 25, 30 minutes, but I was a little bit longer. But we know that when God has his way, God has his way. Amen. So we thank God for all the people of God today. Amen. We're going to go to the book of Psalms. We're going to look at Psalms, the scripture reading, Psalms 37. We're going to read verses 23 and 24. I will give you my thought, and I will give you what I have, and then we will go forth. Amen. So we thank God once again today for all the blessings, Before I do that, let us pray. Father God, we thank you today, dear God. Lord, we just thank you for your mercy, dear Lord, and we thank you for your grace, dear God. Lord, we thank you for being with us in this troubling times, dear God. Lord, you said in your word that you would never leave us nor forsake us. And God, we thank you for your mighty power. Thank you for your hand being up, bestowed upon us, dear God. Lord, we thank you for your mercy. We thank you for your grace. Lord, we just thank you for keeping us, dear God. Lord, we pray for those families who have lost loved ones due to the coronavirus. But God, we thank you because we know that we have a Savior in this day and time. Lord, we just give you thanks and we give praise in all that you do. Amen. And in Jesus' name, we give thanks. Amen. Amen. Once again, we're going to go to Psalms 37. We're going to read verses 23 and 24. Amen. And again, we're going to ask you to, at home, if you're at home, to grab your Bibles, please. Get out the bed. Amen. Get the family. Go get your sons, your daughters. Come to the living room and have church with us today. Amen. Even though that you're absent in body, you're not absent with us in spirit. But we thank God. Psalms 37, 23rd verse, it says, "The steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord. He delights in his way." 24th verse, "Though he fall, he shall not be utterly cast down. For the Lord upholds him with his hand." Amen. So with those two verses today, I want to use for a little thought today, a little text, or whatever you want to say. Recovering from a great fall. I mean, I don't know about you, but many of us have fallen before. We have fell, whether you were at a grocery store or were you in some place and you fell, you hurt your knee, whatever. But a lot of times we fall, but even though we may fall, we can recover. Amen. So we can recover from a great fall. Recovering from a great fall. I will tell you this: if you live long enough, you will have some falls, but. And I heard Donnie McClurkin sing a song says, "We fall down, but we get up." But a saint is just a sinner who will fall, but got back up again. Amen. So I believe that when we fall, we can recover from that fall. But as we read this passage of scripture, David is contrasting the blessings of the righteous and the calamity of the wicked. Amen. So as I begin to read these passages of scripture, there are seven things that God will do for the righteous, and we should strive to be righteous. Amen. We're not righteous by our own works, but we're made righteous through Jesus Christ. Amen. So, but there are seven things that God will do for the righteous. The first thing that God will do is he will order his steps. And when I read that, amen, I don't know about you, but I want God to order my steps. I want him to establish where I'm going. And I know for a fact, that when God leads you, he will not lead you in the wrong direction. He will always lead you in the right direction. Amen. So we thank God for that. He will order. The first thing he will do is order our steps. Okay. The second thing that God does, he delights in his ways. So when you are a righteous person, your aim should be to please God. And when you please God, he delights in what you're doing. Amen. How many of y'all want to please God today? Amen. Our goal should be to please God. So we please God by being obedient to God and walking in his statutes and walking in his ways. And when we do that, God will delight in us. He will bless us. And I don't know about you, but I would like to be blessed today. I've counted a blessing that God is happy with my lifestyle and the things that I'm doing. Amen. So the third thing that would happen the third thing that God will do to the righteous is he will not utterly cast him down. The scripture says, though he fall, he will not utterly cast him down. Sometimes we're going to have some falls. Amen. Being 50-something years old, I've had a couple of falls in my lifetime. But the thing about it is when we fall down, we don't stay down. We have to find a way to get back up and continue to going on. Amen. We are going to have some falls. Amen. So, but Psalms 40 and 1 and 2 says, "I waited patiently for the Lord. He inclined unto me and heard my cry." The second verse says, "He brought me out of a horrible pit and the miry clay." set my feet up on a rock and establish my goings. So when you fall, I know that God will pick you up. He will set your feet up on a solid foundation, and he will lead you and guide you into the direction that you need to go. Amen. So David writes that Psalm 41 and 2. Waiting patiently. Sometimes we just have to wait patiently for the Lord. He will hear us when we cry out to him. Amen. Sometimes when we fall, we need help. Amen. I heard a scripture that says, I will look to the hills which cometh my help, for my help cometh from the Lord. So we have to understand that when we fall, we have somebody to pick us up and to restore us again. Amen. So we thank God that God will pick us up. Okay. There are two types of fall that we can recover from. Amen. The first is a physical fall. As a child, most of us have fell before. There's a time we outside playing as kids, you do this, you do that, and as a physical fall. And as I began to think about the physical fall, I began to think of a man in the Old Testament by the name of Mephibosheth. In fact, that's a tongue twister, but I'm going to try to pronounce that. Mephibosheth, that's his name. Okay, and so we have to understand something about Mephibosheth. The Bible tells us that at the age of 30, that he lost his father and his grandfather had died. And we have to understand that his grandfather was Saul. His grandfather was a king. And the Bible says that he lost his father and his grandfather, which was Jonathan and Saul. So if we look at Mephibosheth, by right, according to Jewish custom, he had every right to have a right to be an heir to the throne, to be a king. Amen. But the Bible says that his nurse was running and she dropped him. And when she dropped him, he became lame. Now, as I began to look at Mephibosheth, he became lame at the hands of someone else's negligence. Amen. So sometimes we fall, but it's not our fault. But sometimes when we fall, it's at the negligence of someone else. I just want to tell you that you have to be careful who is handling you. Amen. I see the nurse, she became very, she neglected to handle him with care. She was a little clumsy. I don't know what the situation was, but the Bible says that she fell. And when he fell, the Bible says that he became lame. Now he's in a situation where he has lost his grandfather and his father, and now he is lame. Amen. So, but I do believe that God is going to restore Mephibosheth. Amen. He's going to recover from this great fall. And how God does it is that by him supposed to be a king, David calls for Mephibosheth for an error of Saul and said, bring Saul's descendants to the table. So even though Mephibosheth had failed and was lame, he got a chance to eat at the king's table. What I'm trying to get you to realize, even though that you may fall, you don't have to stay where you at. You can get up and recover from whatever you have fallen from. Maybe you have fallen from grace. Maybe you have fallen back into sin. Maybe you have fallen back into this. Maybe you have fallen back into a bad relationship. Wherever you have fallen back into, I want you to understand that you can recover. Amen. And I thank God for recovery. I thank God for restoration. Amen. God will restore us. Mephibosheth was restored. He got a chance to eat at the king's table. Amen. All right. So the second fall that we can experience is a spiritual fall. And I want to talk about Adam on that one. I mean, we know that what God did, God made a garden and placed Adam in a garden. And God told Adam that there's all these trees, you can eat of these trees, but don't eat of the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. And the day you eat of that tree, you shall surely die. And Adam became disobedient. And when he disobedient, the Bible says that he sinned. And when Adam ate of that fruit of that tree, the Bible says he sinned. And the day that he ate of that tree, the Bible says that he died. So sometimes when we fall, it's because of someone else's fault, but sometimes it's because of our own fault. When Adam fell from grace, it was his own fault because he disobeyed God. And the Bible says that Adam was cast out of the presence of God. And so what he did was he sinned. And so what we have to understand that sin separates us from God. Now, in Romans 3 and 23, it says, we all have sinned, and come short of God's glory. All right? So we all have sinned because of Adam's sin, because of Adam's disobedience. All of humanity is born into sin. And so we can blame Adam for that. Amen? But God had a plan in mind to recover us all from the sin of Adam. Amen? And what God does, and because of Adam, all of humanity is in sin, born in sin, and shaped into iniquity. But God had a plan to restore us from this, to recover, that we may recover from this great fall. God will send his only begotten Son, which is Jesus, the second Adam, to restore us, to redeem us from the hand of the enemy and from sin. So we have a remedy for the fall of sin. Amen. Jesus is the only way that we could be redeemed from sin. Amen. Now, here's what we have to understand, that God restores us. But in John 3:16, it says, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believe in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. See, God has restored the fall of Adam. We are restored from that fall of sin once again, so we can recover. I don't know what your situation is. You may be in sin. You may have fallen from God's grace. But I want you to understand that God has a remedy to restore you from the fall of sin. And that remedy is Jesus Christ. Amen? Amen. So we have to understand that. But I did want to go back to the 17th verse. The 17th verse says, God did not send his Son into the world to condemn us, but that through him that we might be saved. So God sends his only Son to redeem us from the great fall, to recover. We can recover. Whatever sin that you have fallen into, you have a remedy to recover. Amen. And the only way that we can recover is by accepting Jesus as our Lord and Savior. Amen. Accepting Jesus as our Lord and Savior. Amen. I want to read one more scripture. I'm almost done. I'm almost about to close. In Romans 5 and 8, it says, But God demonstrates his love toward us, that while we were yet sinners, yet he died for us. And what we have to understand, that God knew that Adam was going to eat of that tree. So what God does, God already had a plan in place for Adam's sin. Not only Adam's sin, but he had a plan in place for my sins. He had a plan in place for your sins. So the only way we can be restored is by accepting Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior. Now, in conclusion, I'm about to come to a close. In my conclusion, Jude 1:24 says, now unto him who is able to keep us from falling, to present you faultless in the presence of his glory and with exceeding glory. So now unto him who is able to keep us from falling, we have to understand that God is able to keep us from falling, whether it's a physical fall or a spiritual fall. So I hope you have enjoyed the word today, that if you fall, if you sin, if you are a backslider, God has a remedy for you. He has a plan for you to restore you, to get you back up again and go on your way. All you have to do is repent and accept Jesus as your personal Lord and Savior. Amen. And your sins will be forgiven. I thank God that my sins are forgiven. I don't care what sin you have committed, your sins are forgiven. You could be a murderer. You could be a child molester. You could be a fornicator. You could be an adulterer. Whatever sin that you have fell into, God is able to pick you up from that sin and redeem you and forgive you for your sins. I thank God that God had a plan in place when I mess up. Amen. I can say that God is going to clean up what we have messed up. Amen. So I hope you have enjoyed the word today. Amen.